willing to help us out because our other options did not pan out at all as far as finding other qualified individuals to step in to run the program here in-house. So Jen has notes and things that she has taken, and she has done an amazing job this weekend. I think she feels related to some of these people at the JCC. She spent so much time talking to them. Jen, you let me know when you are.
I'm just a minute, I'm ready when you are.
Okay, then feel free to please share what we've been able to work out with the JCC.
Sure. So we'll start by, and I want to thank the JCC because they're amazing. The fact that they were able to get people on a Friday night, Saturday morning, Sunday, all day. You know, we are very, I'm very grateful that they could do that. I also want to thank Mrs. Bird over at the school, and I'll explain why in a minute, for just being an amazing administrator and helping us out for all things as well. So first and foremost, obviously everybody knows that we had a change on Friday that caused us to kind of have to reevaluate and figure out what we're doing. We reached out to the JCC to see what their options were and what they could do. After negotiating and conversations and all the pieces put together, what we came up with is they are willing to take 46 of our families. That is the max that they can take. They will take 46 of our families, but they cannot run the program unless we have 25 that are willing to come over. Their going rate is $30 a day. And I know that's a hit because right now we're $12 a day. I negotiated them down to $20 a day. That also includes a bus because we would need to go to the JCC. The bus is around $200 a day, and they were willing to split it with us. So it's $100 for us, $100 for them. So that way we could manage the expenses that way as well. They do have different hours than we do. They can only do 3:30 to 5:30, where we are right after school here, though it doesn't make a difference on the actual start time because the bus has to pick them up and bring them over. So their start time is 3:30 to 5:30. Ours is normally until 6. So there's a half an hour difference there. They don't have people till 6. So it would have to be a hard stop at the 5:30. They also have religious days that they would have to have off, particularly October. They have several in October. There is no care for those days because they are shut down. During vacation weeks, they are more than willing to take them for the vacation weeks as well. Again, the number still sticks at 46. It's a license issue. So they can take them. And right now, we charge $195. A week. They charge $475 a week. That got reduced down to $425, so they took $10 off a day per kid. Our hours were, including our after-hour program, were 8:30 to 6 during the vacations. Theirs are 9 to 5, I believe. I would have to double check with them. We went back and forth on a couple of things and we're still finalizing some pieces. So I'm going to say 9 to 5, but it might be 5:30. But I don't want to say that without double checking with them. Again, the bus, the fees with that were split in half. So it would be $200 a day, but it would cost us $500 a week instead of $1,000. So again, the differences here, we have a minimum with our program. We don't have one, right? If we have four or five kids, we could find, we had staff here, we could take them. If we, you know, for them, you have to have 25. They cannot take more than 46. So that's their max for there. That being said as well, currently right now, we have 11 staff members that were after school care counselors. I also work with the JCC, and they are willing to look at them as potential additional staff, as they will be looking for additional staff, obviously, for all the kids. So they would have to go through their procedure and get through them. They have some additional trainings that they do because they have pools and rock walls and all kinds of activities that they want to make sure that they have different type of training. So they would have to get hired through them, but they are more than welcome to apply, and they're sending me over applications so that we can talk that through with the staff. So that is the after school program. There's still a there's still a situation with our before program. Our before program, I had reached out to Kay, I'm sorry, Mrs. Berg, over at BCS, and I know that they were trying to put together a program for an after school program and a before school program. Right now, their after school program, they're still looking for staff, so it's not a viable option. Obviously, that was the first place I started. So what they had come up with is they probably, I have not been given a 100%, but she is, I just talked to her at 4 o'clock today. She is very confident that she can get together a before program that could run all year. I apologize, one caveat I did not mention. The JCC has to have a contract till June. So if they're going to do all the training and all the things, they want to make sure that we're there for the duration of this year. So that is the other caveat to that. So I talked to Mrs. Bird, and she is aware that that would go until June for a before program. And she said that she feels comfortable doing a soft opening for a before program for current registered before program through the town currently right now. And then we'll see how that goes and how many staff members she gets and things like that. And then we'll go from there. I did not discuss price with her at this point. We were literally just trying to get program and staff and all of those pieces. So that is a follow-up that I still need to do. So that is where we are at right now with what we are doing over.
And basically, we are looking, the money piece of it will go to the Board of Finance for approval. We are basically recommending this forward to them so that we can move forward with cost, any fees and stuff like that. So that's...
Well, can you elaborate on what you're presenting to Board of Finance? What are you offering to pay for that cost of busing? And
well, that's going to be a conversation. Well, yes. Obviously, we have to cover the bus. As far as the additional fees and what it's going to cost, that's going to be a conversation with the Board of Finance. If they choose to subsidize anything in addition to the bus, that's their conversation. We don't control that money. They do.
No, I understand that. My question is, will you be recommending that they cover that cost for families? You could say, I recommend this
right.
for families.
We can discuss that right now, if that's what we want to do.
Rather than coming from this first select woman, that should come as a recommendation from this body.
That's what I feel.
I was just asking her opinion. I haven't spoken with her at all, so I'm just asking her opinion on whether she supports the town covering those costs for families.
Yes, we can talk about, is it a year-long subsidy? Is it only for a set amount of months? Those are conversations that will be a final decision by the Board of Finance, but that's what we can recommend is this program to help families out with an after-school program. Then we will finalize with the school the before piece, finding out what the cost of that potentially could be. So we need to just move this forward to the Board of Finance so that we can move the monies at their level, at their board.
The $500 a week for the bus would be a little under $20,000, I'm guessing, for the end of the year.
We're into, yes. But yeah, we're almost at 12 months. Yeah, 10 months. So
there are vacation weeks,
but that's not good.
Right. Just to fall apart.
We have honestly the amount of conversation, and some of it is literally continuing until about 5:15 tonight. That those pieces will be coming. This is because there's a real time constraint on this. If we want this program to open on Monday, parents have to be able to submit documentation to the JCC by Thursday morning for a Monday open. So it doesn't give a lot of time. So I have promised multiple parents that I've talked to for the last couple of days that pending this meeting and the next meeting, I was going to send out informative email with any type of packet. I've already received all the packets from the JCC, so that's not a problem. Like I said, the school portion, I'm still waiting, but that's not as much of an issue because they already go to the school. It's just filling out their registration form for the actual program itself. She said she would send that over shortly. But it is something that if the board decides they want a program next week, this is the avenue to go.
Right. I did have a question on JCC too. You said 46 is all they can take in Woodbridge, right?
Yep.
So obviously there's some time constraints because if other people from different towns go there in the meantime, you're fewer, that almost equals the number of people that were signed up for.
Right. I mean, there's a few, so right now I believe, and I apologize, I tried my best with my rec. I don't know my rec. I was pulling reports. They're all different days because some people do 2, 4, 5 days or 3, 4, 5 days. But it looks right around that 50 mark that we have. However, talking also with the JCC, you know, they talk to the community. And today when I had the conversation with them, they said that some folks have already signed on with other daycares or things like that. Now, I don't know if that's on a weekly, monthly, yearly, you know, if we have an annual, obviously that's not going to be something that they can go to the JCC at this point. But, you know, we could have a little flex there as far as, you know, what those numbers look like. But 46 is as close as I could get to. The number that we currently have, because there's a licensure issue and they are opening up a kind of like a separate program just for us. And so obviously there will be co-mingle kit, but they're opening up an entire new section just to accommodate us. And so they have been scrambling to get this together for us. They've been amazing.
Pulling it together over the
weekend. They've been amazing, absolutely amazing.
And then you mentioned 25, that's because they're doing this program, like a separate program for us.
Correct. But 46 is their max. And so they're holding the entirety of that entire new program for us, which is why they said they won't do it unless we have a minimum of 25. Because to make it worth them for them, they're not going to lose money. So 25 is the min that they can do.
I don't know. Well, I personally don't think long term that other taxpayers and people in town would want to subsidize. But because of how it's evolved, I think for this year, the town should.
Well, that will be up to the Board of Finance, the length of time that they want to subsidize. Is it 6 months? Is it the entire year? That'll be their conversation. So, you know, so.
Well, that's kind of what we're approving, right?
Right.
If we're agreeing to a year, then it's.
It has to be till June.
Well, yeah, they want us to commit to the program for the school year.
Okay.
So to have a motion.
Well, we were subsidizing Park and Rec anyway to $100,000, and if taxpayers probably don't know about that, but I want to say I support paying for the bus, paying for the cost differential. I have a question about whether what Surrey Brook may have said, and this is coming from an email I received from a parent who thought that Surrey Brook would be contacted. I'm not sure if it was in the context of my motion on Tuesday asking you look into programs and what costs would be.
This happened on Friday afternoon.
No, but my motion was Tuesday. So this.
I did not look into Surrey Brook, but I apologize.
Okay. No, you don't have to apologize. I just want for my own information and just the idea that this was discussed even before Tuesday when this motion was had. So was Bunny Village contacted or Bethany Nursery Group? I think there was some email today about a place in Prospect.
But I don't know if those take like sixth graders.
No, I'm just asking so I have information about whether or not they were contacted.
No.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Due to time constraints, I want us to stay on point here because I know Mr. Britton has to get to another meeting. I don't want to bounce the Board of Finance off of their 6:30 start as well. So, do I have a motion to move this proposal forward to the Board of Finance for conversation with them for any funding?
Well, just to be clear, it's for funding for the busing and for the cost differential.
Potential subsidizing of the cost differential.
So move.
Yes. Second.
Oh, we're subsidizing the cost differential.
No, we're just moving that thought forward to the Board of Finance. That will be their conversation.
Or are you making it as a recommendation of this body?
The Board of Finance would love a recommendation from the
That's my motion, to make a recommendation forward with regard to this program and any potential funding that comes along with it.
Yeah, I don't think we should fund the cost differential.
Well, that's we have to vote on that, and then it'll be their final decision with the Board of Finance. I have no issue with them having the conversation.
Did you have a motion, or did I? My motion was to pay for the busing and to, for the, as well as the cost differential to families.
Right, we're recommending
that's
that.
That's the recommendation.
Right, with this program and any substantial, yeah, I can't even think of the word, subsequent costs that come along with subsidizing or.
So that was a motion, you need a second.
I think Bob second.
Bob's on the fence.
No, I was asking. We're trying to figure out what the motion was.
Oh, we got it.
Because it was like first, it was like we're going
to
move it.
You want us to repeat it?
No, it's to pay for half to commit to a year.
To recommend committing to the school year.
The school year.
For the after
pay for
school
half
program.
The bus, which is $100 a week.
Yeah, $500 a week. It's
$100 a day. Yeah, $500.
$100 a day.
Yeah, and then the cost differential, which is pretty significant.
Can be potential, but like I say, we're recommending that suggestion forward to the Board of Finance, and then it will be up to them to make the decision as to what.
Bob, given what we're paying our attorneys more and more every day, given what we're paying the investigator that's coming, it's the least we could do for people.
Well, okay.
How all much? Right. How much is it?
It's an $8 differential a day per child. If the vacation is where there's a big difference, it's $425.
Well, that'll be a conversation for them. Do they just right. do the subsidy for the school year and vacations are separate? That'll be a conversation.
We need a recommendation on all items. Yes. Yeah. Board of Finance would like a recommendation on all items.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not going to support that. I don't think we should do the subsidy of the tuition or the
well, I'll second Gina's motion.
I'm surprised you approved the $100,000 subsidy to Park and Rec.
Did we?
Let's move on. Let's stay on point. Let's not veer off
I'm
the track.
I'm on point.
I seconded your motion, Gina.
Okay. Great. And then motion passes.
The motion has been seconded. Now you have discussion. If you want discussion,
I think we've hashed it out.
We've discussed, and it's unique. It's two to one.
Oh, yeah,
We voted. We voted in favor of moving this forward as the potential subsidy of the costs.
So. Okay, and I'll vote no.
She's done that. Okay, moving right along. All right, item number three is this discussion and possible action, overall status of the Park and Recreation Department. Here's the thought. The after-school and before and after-school program is a separate piece at this point because it's now going to be sort of outsourced to a third party to the JCC. But we still have a Park and Rec department because there potentially are other programs that we can run through a Park and Rec department, even if it is a program coordinator who oversees potentially Bethany Hoops, any cooking classes, art classes, kids yoga, anything along those lines where it's additional programs besides a before and after school program. So we had approved at a previous meeting to have a special meeting next Thursday to appoint members to the commission. So right now, the way the town code is set, it's up to 7 members. Right now, everybody who would be appointed for a 2-year term. As I had mentioned at previous meetings, the Town Code Review Committee meets in October, and I'm going to ask that they review this particular code for revisions, because it really needs to be looked at. It shouldn't say up to a certain number. It should have a set number. And I'm going to make a recommendation that it go along the lines of sort of like the Planning and Zoning Commission, where they have 5 set members and they have 3 alternates, because that always allows them to have a quorum to have a meeting. If you just set it at a set number and you don't reach your quorum, then you can't have meetings. But the Planning and Zoning always is able to have a meeting because they have the alternates that are able to rotate in if members are regular members are missing. So that's going to be one of my recommendations. Another part of the conversation for the commission is going to be staggered terms, because right now you have 5 commission members coming on at the same time and they're off at the same time.
doesn't help for any continuity to the commission. So that's another recommendation that I'm going to ask. Third is length of term. Right now it's a two-year term. If we start with staggered terms, it's going to kind of be offset 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, whatever. But what is the potential recommended length? Is 2 years too short? Is 4 years too long? So that's going to be a conversation for that review committee to kind of banter around. Any changes that they do make will be brought to a town meeting for approval. So it will be up to the townspeople to approve that town code when it is formalized. So basically, right now, there really is no, I don't know if there really is a motion or a vote on this, because we are looking to put the commission together and then work with the commission to have a scope of work to look at what programs we can offer. Do we need a director? Do we need a programs coordinator? So these are going to be discussions down the road. But next week, we will hopefully be able to put a commission together so we can start moving with that piece. Because right now, the before and after school is separate, and the programs, another piece. But we want to be able to offer other programs to the townspeople. You know, because I know Bethany Hoops has always been a very popular one, because we have a lot of kids who like to play hoops. And so that's where we are with that. Was I pretty succinct?
Yes.
I think?
Mostly an update.
Well, it was pretty much an update, because it will be getting a committee together to potentially run some programs. So I appreciate everyone's due diligence and time and patience on this. It's been a very difficult weekend. Jen, thank you. I know we were reaching out to all kinds of other, you know, groups and stuff, but you went above and beyond the call of duty with this. And like I said, I did promise them this. I'm kidding. We'll get them a coffee or something, whatever. I do thank everyone, and I truly, truly appreciate your patience and understanding. This was a curveball for us a little bit, but we are going to move forward in a positive direction, and we will hopefully, it'll be okay. We will be okay. All right. Can I have a?
Oh, is that meeting on the 14th? I mean, not the 14th,
the 19th.
The Thursday.
Yeah. Seeing so that we can get Board of Finance into their meeting on time. Do I have a motion to adjourn, please?
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you very much, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your evening.